Yeah. So this is something we discussed a few days ago when Oracle was up, you know, sharply at that point. They didn't disclose the name of the client, but that seems like, you know, as we said, it is OpenAI. This is part of the Stargate project that came out right after the president got elected at the beginning of January or the middle of the end of Jan. This is a big project. It's going to take several years to build out. It's going to be humongous data centers across the country and perhaps even globe, where OpenAI is basically buying computing capacity from Oracle with the help of SoftBank, you know, funding part of that particular project.
What is your sense of this deal? Because we have credit ratings, S&P saying that Oracle Cloud's infrastructure building spree was straining cash flow and that the current spending pace is higher than anticipated. Is that also the view you have?
Yeah, it's going to be much higher. In fact, we think the company gave guidance of about CapEx of $25 billion. We think that's going to be low. It's going to be, you know, well north of that over the long term. I mean, over the next 3 to 5 years. Remember, just a few years ago, they were only spending about $5-6 billion a year. But frankly speaking, if you really want to play in the cloud infrastructure game or AI infrastructure game, you really need to spend the money up front in order to get those workloads down the road. Microsoft is spending, Amazon is spending, and you know, frankly, for Oracle's, you know, good fortune, they actually have a client who's willing to pay them ahead of time, or they have an agreement so that they can go out and build this data center and they can recognize revenue over the next few years.
Oracle will develop multiple data centers across the U.S. with partners, with sites in several states under consideration, including Texas, Michigan, and Wisconsin here. Where does Oracle fit within kind of your broader AI theme, Anurag?
Yeah, just about 5 years ago, to be honest, they were pretty much absent in this game because their cloud infrastructure was there to take care of their clients only, and you know, nobody else was renting it from them. I mean, there were certain clients, but not so big. I think the TikTok deal really made, you know, helped them out because TikTok runs on Oracle Cloud infrastructure. They gave them some credibility. You know, they've been spending a lot of money to expand their data center footprint. I think they can afford to do that because they have a very incredible, profitable, you know, database business where they are the market leaders. They have a lot of cloud applications where they generate a lot of free cash flow. So they established this business and now they're getting the reaping the benefit of it. As it relates to, let's say, AWS, they're still very small in size. And their infrastructure as a service business last year did $10 billion in revenue, as compared to, let's say, Amazon, which is running at about $100 billion or so. But this particular customer, or this customer and a few others, by FY28 will add another $30 billion on top of the 10 that we are talking about. So their cloud business really becomes much stronger down the road because of this deal.
What about Microsoft? Lots of news here, too. Their gaming division laid off hundreds of employees, and specific to Xbox, this is the fourth mass layoff at least in the last 18 months. What is their strategy here?
The strategy, I think, is by the CEO saying, listen, you use these AI tools, become more productive, and I'm not going to hire at the same pace as we used to hire before. And I think that is the game now. I think this is going to go on and carry on to other tech firms, whether it's on the software landscape or any of the other subsectors. But I think you're going to see this theme recurring over the next 12 months where CEOs are saying, you really need to figure out your productivity before you ask for a headcount. And I think that is, frankly speaking, that's not good for the downstream players, people who are selling software packages to these companies, HR software, sales software. But, you know, there's not a whole lot anybody can do about it at this point.